Welcome to Sly Cooper, Thieves in Time. I'm James, your host. Let's get started. Of course I want to save the data. Yeah, I want the full story. Of course I do.
I should probably just start at the beginning. The name's Sly. Sly Cooper. And I'm a thief. From a long line of thieves. In fact, thieving is the family business. And business was good. Although, until recently, I considered myself retired. Having hung up my mask and cane, I was enjoying life on the other side of the law. In the company of a certain lovely Interpol agent named Carmelita Fox. She and I had a history which generally involved her trying to lock me up. So I should mention our current situation was only possible because she thought I had amnesia. I didn't. It was great to finally enjoy each other's company without a shock pistol being involved, and we quickly put the past behind us. But as time went on, the old itch came back, and I knew I needed to pull a heist. I should also mention that as a master thief, I only steal from other thieves. So it took me a while, but I finally found what I was looking for. My target was an upstart art mogul, a real hotshot collector. He seemed respectable, had even opened a new museum. But I could smell a rat. Reliable sources told me he was dealing in black market antiques worth millions. So I felt he should share the wealth. I was working on a plan when one night, as if on cue, Bentley showed up. Bentley was the brains of our operation, the mastermind. We grew up in the same orphanage where we bonded over stealing cookies, our very first heist. And we've been best friends and partners ever since. We hadn't seen each other for a while, but I knew immediately that something was up. His time off too, building a new lab from scratch with his girlfriend and fellow tech whiz, Penelope. She had joined the team on our last caper, and the two of them had really hit it off. Apparently, they just finished work on a top secret project when Penelope had simply vanished. Bentley was worried sick. He searched frantically but found nothing. Then, he noticed something that completely stunned him. In his spare time, Bentley had been researching the Thievius Raccoonus, the Master Thieves Handbook passed down through the Cooper family for generations. Its pages overflowing with the exploits and secret techniques of my esteemed ancestors. Only now, those pages weren't so full. In fact, they were disappearing right before Bentley's eyes. Realizing there was no time to waste, he gathered his gear and raced off to Paris. The first thing Bentley did was track down Murray, the third in our trio. Murray was our enforcer, the muscle, and the guy who'd eaten all the cookies we stole back in our orphanage days. Through the years, the three of us had become an unbeatable team, and we were more like a family now than a gang. Murray had been living his dream on the pro driving circuit, where his van had become famous, or rather infamous, for all the crashes he'd caused. Eventually, he was unable to find a sponsor due to his high insurance premiums, and he moved into demolition derby. where he remained undefeated. When Bentley showed up, however, Murray dropped everything to help out. Especially when Bentley explained that his van was the key to the whole plan. With Carmelita distracted by a new assignment, I took the opportunity to slip away and met up with the guys at our old Paris hideout. Bentley launched into one of his elaborate presentations, and I saw the whole scary picture. Someone, or something, was literally erasing Cooper history. Then, to our amazement, Bentley revealed that he already had the solution. Time travel. It turns out his top secret project was constructing a time machine. And now he modified the design to fit into Murray's van. We were going to travel back in time, stop those responsible, and fix the damage they'd done. Bentley explained the only catch was that in order to travel to a particular time, the machine required an object from that era. We knew from the changes to the Thievius Raccoonus that our first stop was feudal Japan. So here we were, about to steal a priceless 17th century samurai dagger from the same museum I'd been casing. Funny how things work out sometimes.
Yeah, look at the graphics on this. Sanzaro, you really outdone yourself.
Okay, you both remember the plan, right?
Of course! My mind is like a steel cap!
That's trash, big guy. And everybody relax. We've been over it a million times. What could possibly go wrong?
Famous last words. Look. We're only gonna get one shot at this, so we can't mess up.
All right, no messing up allowed. Now stop worrying. This is gonna be a piece of cake. I'll see you both inside. Now let's get going.
Yeah, this is definitely going to be fun. Anybody's played Sly Cooper before names there.
That's how I pull off some of my best moves.
I knew it'd get me. The odds were against me from the start.
I remember. That's how I pull off some of my best moves.
Those choppers fly. If they see now, we're busted.
I think
think I can handle that.
Wrong way.
Hey, Bentley, was truck surfing part of Murray's entrance strategy?
Of course not. Murray's approach route is through the back alleys. Why do you ask?
No reason. Anyway, it looks like he's in position now.
Make sure you stay on these cables, Sly. You can't risk going down to street level right now.
Not a problem, Bentley. A good thief prefers to stay above the action anyway. Looks like the perfect night for a heist.
Well, at least to make some money anyway.
Ghost, I promise.
It sure feels good to be back in business.
I don't believe this. These camera angles are driving me nuts. I'll say.
That was too close.
Yeah, that's much better. I hate having to adjust my camera in 10 seconds.
I'm a little out of practice.
You say something, Sly?
No. All good here, Bentley.
Okay. It looks like you're going to have to find another way up. Use that ledge to move around to the front of the museum and stay out of that security light.
I think I can handle that. I can't believe the security of this place. This better be worth it.
Tomato juice box. Now, most gamers, when they come through something like this, they get in a big hurry to get to the end. I don't. That's why I got 500 extra points there. I bet you didn't think I saw that, did you? Well, I didn't mean to do that. It's a good thing I did, because I missed this one. Come on. Thing wasn't anywhere near me. Huh? Come on. That's what gets you killed. The damn pop-up menus.
Like somebody spent a fortune on this place.
Naturally.
I wonder what
the museum
inside.
First things first, Bentley.
Let me know when you shut down the security system.
Patience, Sly. You can't rush greatness, and I'm about to code a hacking masterpiece. Interesting. The last time I was in these sewers, I was just a teenager. My Bob should make short work of that grate. I just need to press the truck. Well, that was a blast. Jump. I better use the hover pack here. If I jump, then press and hold. Thank you, technology.
You mean thank you, Sanzaro. Tutorials.
Great, that platform is blocked. I'll have to throw a bomb to clear it off. If I press and hold the L1 button, I can bring up my rangefinder. Then I can adjust the range of my throw by pressing forward or backward on the left stick. That's a direct hit. Blech. If I fall in that filthy water, I'm buying a new shell. Huh.
Billy sure has overcome this handicap thing.
To the schematics, the control room is right underneath me, and voila, instant shortcut. Phew, talk about your close shaves.
How's that security system coming, Bentley?
Great, perfect. I'll be done in a jiffy. Next time, I'm giving Sly the sewer job.
Wow.
Now for a patented Bentley hack attack.
That was something you don't see all the time. Is this a new weapon? Talk about a high-tech tank. That was interesting.
That's the way the cone base crumbles.
Okay, Murray, you're up.
The Murray is always on, Bentley.
Okay, Murray, we need to get you back in fighting shape. Why don't you warm up with a few basic attacks? Press the square button to punch.
Oh, yeah! The old muscle memory is really kicking in.
Press and hold the triangle button to charge up.
Hey, kicking my butt.
Wicked spinning attack.
Yes! Nobody can withstand the pink tornado!
To perform a thunder flop, jump, then press the triangle button while in the air.
Oh, thunder flop, how I've missed you!
I'm running out of health here.
You punks better call for backup.
Where things are going, I better call for backup. Well, they give you enough health packs.
You fools don't stand a chance!
Ooh, I missed a trash can. Well, we're almost back to full strength. It's a good thing. Look at this guy.
I'm getting bored here.
All right, make your way to the loading dock. You've got to take out all the guards before I can open the gate.
You punks better call for backup.
Could be one more, two more. Hey man, I'm making money outside. Pump the air button.
Got to fool with the Murray. I call that. That felt great.
Everything okay, Murray?
Now it is.
Murray, don't forget to use your throwing ability. Press the circle button to stop near an object, and you will pick it up. Then press the square button to throw the object. If you press the triangle button instead, you can slam the object down.
Okay, Sly. The security system is down. You're all clear.
Great. I'm going in. What the?
You didn't really think you were gonna get away with it, did you?
Check Carmelita out. She gets better look for an animal, she gets better looking every game.
Hey, Carmelita! Funny meeting you here.
Sly Cooper, you no good lying thief. I'm locking you up for good.
Sorry, gotta take a rain check. I'll call you.
Cooper!
Good evening, this is Sly Cooper. I'd like to request a ride.
You, Sly. Now quit messing around and get down here. We're in the van. It's ready to roll.
Au revoir. Let's hit it.
Buckle up, boys! Oh, yeah! Just like in a demolition derby!
Look out! Oh, I think I cracked myself. Watch out for those trees! Where are you going?
Just setting up for the jump! Welcome to Air Murray! Thanks for flying!
Nice landing, Murray. Hey, Bentley, not to complain, but we're kind of trapped here.
Relax, Sly. Just put the dagger in the receptacle. Perfect. Isotopic decay calibrated. Adjusting fusion synthesis. Anytime you want to punch it, Murray.
You got it, chump.
Do not slow down, Murray.
I never do. Whoa!
Well, what else can I say about Carmelita? As you can see, our relationship is complicated. And I just succeeded in upgrading it to hazardous. I certainly wasn't expecting her to crash the party. She'd been so busy with her latest case, I never thought she'd have her eye on me. In fact, I'd kind of been counting on it. But then, I should have known better than to underestimate Inspector Carmelita Fox. As much as she liked having fun, Carmelita was serious about her police work. And now, I had a lot of explaining to do. But the plan was in motion, and there was no stopping now. Even though I was thinking I'd need the time machine just to patch things up with Carmelita. Before the heist, we recruited our disco-loving, scuba-diving friend, Dimitri Lestow, to look after the devious raccoons. Because it was irreplaceable and the only guide we had, it was far too risky to take the book through time with us. Bentley had even invented a communication device to allow us to contact Dimitri no matter where or when we traveled. It was a perfect situation, since it allowed him to update us on any changes to the book while limiting our exposure to his fashion critiques. Everything was happening so fast. The past few days were just a blur. But as we howled through the time vortex, I realized we were in for a very long trip.
It would appear that's the prologue, and it's interesting. The graphics on this are just too much for words. Of course, Carmelita's changed in dress over the years. Her voice has also changed. Sly's a little fuller.
We needed to locate Ryuichi Cooper, Master Ninja, and Master Chef. According to the Cooper clan history, Ryuichi Cooper was actually the inventor of sushi. After creating this delectable dish, he opened a sushi restaurant, which, while very prosperous, also provided the perfect cover for a ninja. When we got to Japan, it was obvious something was very wrong.
What should have been a peaceful village was more like a heavily patrolled military base. We located Ryuichi's sushi restaurant, only to find it shut down and under guard. Things got worse when Bentley discovered that Ryuichi was locked up in a new high-security jail, allegedly for serving bad sushi to the shogun. It all sounded like a pretty tough piece of fish to swallow. We needed to get to the bottom of the situation, and the first order of business was getting Ryuichi out of prison.
Well, that'll do it for the opening prologue. We'll catch you next time for the first mission. Until then, keep...